night service. Not only is that, you know, I stay home, I go on some on a beat, my friend. But when the Spirit of God speaks to you, you better obey.
Amen, amen.
Because sometimes when you tell people, when you come into church, they're shocked and they feel as though you're doing a favor by showing up.
Okay.
You know, little one, I'm finishing just now. I'll show you how dangerous church could be. Right from here. It's a dangerous, dangerous place to be. And so this young man, even the people, even this morning right here, my friends, the Spirit of God is speaking to you. And so it comes to his mind. Comes in his mind. And remind him of where he came from. You don't have to be this way. There's hope for you, son.
Oh, yes.
And he said to himself, how many hired servants of my father have bread enough to spare?
Oh, yes.
And I perish in him. In hope,
oh.
I will arise.
Oh, yes.
And he said, I'll go to my father.
Father.
And I will say to him, Father, I've sinned against heaven. First.
Right.
And against you. Which means that this boy knew God.
Oh yes, he did.
He knew God.
Yes.
He was once in the church.
Oh, yes.
Once following what God says. Once doing what God says. Once taking part in church services, my friends. But he finally looked. The elders go preach.
Alright.
Oh, it's too boring.
Too boring.
Church too boring.
Oh yes.
I mean, sometimes I try to hype up the song service, but me don't enjoy those songs.
My
I rather be poor.
Oh yeah.
The songs of the world. I want to die.
Yes.
And so every day, the devil keeps chipping away on his spiritual experience, chipping away,
oh,
chipping
yes.
away, until he got him to himself. He was openly naked now.
Oh, yeah.
Naked to the devil. And so the devil plunged another thing that's not supposed to be there. When I realize, when I see now where seven Adventists, my friends, who have been in church for years, looking at some of that doctrine, my
oh,
friends,
yeah.
and leaving the church, something is wrong with that person.
Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Going after big fool.
Big fool,
man. But the Spirit of God came to him. And he says, I will arise. Somebody say amen.
Amen.
And I will say to my father, I've sinned against heaven and against you. I'm no more worthy to be called your son. But make me one of the hired servants. And listen to me this morning, church. God wants you to be his son. He wants you to be a servant.
Alright. Amen.
It is dangerous just being a servant. My friends, it is better to be called a servant of Jesus Christ.
Oh yes.
Because anybody could say, I'm a child of God.
Oh yeah.
And when Paul, and then the look of Paul, the state locked him up. Police put him behind bars, chain him down. When he got a little chance with a pen and a paper, he writes, I, a prisoner of Jesus Christ. You know what he's saying? I, a servant of Jesus Christ, not a son, but a servant. Because a servant is different from a son.
Oh, yes.
And until we become servants, ladies and gentlemen, brothers and sisters, until we become servants,
oh, yes.
you'll be lost in the pew. What he said, if even though he don't accept me as a son, and mind you, he couldn't go back and ask the Father for anything. You and I can't go and ask God for nothing. Why? Because for years we have been wasting God's time and wasting his talents and wasting his gifts and wasting his money. We can't go now and ask back because we wasted away. My friend, just go back to God and say, Lord, make me a servant.
Oh yes, amen.
When he was crying out in that pit bed, you know what he was saying? He was saying, Lord, transform me.
Oh yes, amen.
Until we are transformed into what God has us to be, we'll just be sons and daughters of God.
All right.
And that's a dangerous place to be. Just being a son and a daughter of God.
Yes.
Because the bread that was whole, he went up, he didn't take his portion and went up and wasted it. My friends, he kept it there. But you know what? He was lost in church. So he didn't just say, I will arise, but he got up. And the pilot says, my friends, he was in a far country. So it took many days and weeks to reach his destination. He didn't have transport. He was back on his bare feet. He was ragged. My friends, he was smelling. He had not had the odor. His hair grew long and his beard, my friends, had no toothpaste and toothbrush. My friend, but day and night, he wore up. Until in the distance, he saw his father's property. His father was rich.
Yes.
So to reach the house, you had to reach the first piece of land.
Alright.
And many animals were there.
Right.
I could just visualize. You know, there's something about dogs. No matter how you look, dogs don't forget their owner. I had to pick up a dog out there in the field. And when he saw the person coming, I could hear some of the servants say, oh no, who's that coming through master's land? But the dog ran. And the dog began to run there and run there. And began to kick up and dance up and think. I can tell you about our dog home. I never told you before. But we have two dogs. Those dogs, the share my car from crack on the road. I didn't know what you coming in, but I shoot down in the back, run across them, jumping up, glad, happy, and all that. But when I come home, the van will be coming up. They will turn in the head. But Angela, I'm not going to tell you. They don't even turn the head. Because I discipline them. When coming, the bite of things and putting on this. And tell them in the yard. You will come in our yard. You will put a pile of rubbish there and open the rubbish. They ain't going in it. Even if I go in the shed to eat. And I sit down there, they know they're not supposed to watch you. So they will sit. They will sit about our midway there. And their head will be facing that. I'm trying to tell you. Their head will be facing that way. They will watch me. And though they have little screen, they're watching because I'm over there. Turn around. But Marley, that dog, my friends, they knew that there's something about that fella that they knew, and that dog ran to him.
All right.
And began to sort it out and walk it around, and there's different whistles for dogs, and the yells it. And the dog knew the whistle. And began to jump on him, and was glad, even though he was looking like a vagrant. Because he had wasted all that God has given to him. And then when he reached closer, came in to the fence. He began to walk up. The father knew him. And the father ran out, my friends, and he threw his arms. Somebody say amen.
Oh, yes.
Just like this morning, God wants to throw his arms over you.
Oh, yes.
Because, my friend, you don't want to be a son. You want to be a servant.
Amen.
And that's the only time God can feel happy about us. When we choose to be servants of Jesus Christ. When you choose to say, Lord, transform me. And my friends, a servant, when a servant is transformed, it does everything that the master says.
Oh yes, amen.
But a son, if a father tells, the father tells the son that was home to do something because it was his father and his father's in authority, he can tell a servant to do it. Are you hearing me? Huh?
Oh, yeah.
Because he had that authority. They were the same blood. And so he can tell a servant, but then you become a servant whatever the master said, you're willing to do.
Amen.
And today I'm asking you. I'm asking you. You alone can answer that. Because many self-evidence will be lost. And I'm planning by God's grace not to be lost.
Amen, amen.
But many self-evidence will be lost because they are only sons and daughters of God, but not servants. And until you become a servant, then you are playing God's way. A servant actually is a slave. And a slave don't argue back. A slave don't give back thoughts. A slave just carry out the orders of his master. What are you today? The man had two sons. He had how many? How many? He had two sons. One chose to remain a son, but the other one chose to remain, to become a servant. What are you today? Are you a son? Are you a daughter? Or are you a servant? You're not going to answer. God bless you.
Amen.